I'm one of the petitioners in the Scottish case, that just established earlier this morning that Boris Johnson's prorogation of Parliament, his suspension of Parliament,
so congratulations are in order.
Of Parliament as an inconvenience is unlawful.
Yes.
Well, it's not about it's not just about Brexit. This case. Because if the government was right, then Parliament would be able to be suspended at the whim of any Prime Minister for as long as that Prime Minister wanted, and there would be nothing that anyone could do about it. Parliament doesn't get a vote on whether it's suspended. The government said the courts can't get involved with the question whether Parliament is suspended, and we would no longer live in any meaningful sense in a parliamentary democracy. So this is a vital moment in the constitutional history of the United Kingdom.
I understand that. I'm sort of affectionately minded to say you're not in court now, because it did go the other way last week, so it's not quite as cut and dried as some of my listeners may conclude from listening to you, Jolyon Moore. And you will, I think, be in the Supreme Court early next week for an appeal from the government against this.
It is absolutely true that we will be in the Supreme Court next week. And ultimately, the Supreme Court will have to decide whether it agrees with Scotland's highest court or with the Divisional Court of England and Wales.
Right.
But I think I have said consistently since this case started that it was the inner house where things were going to get serious. If you were up here last week, you would have heard me brief journalists before the outer house gave its decision that we would lose before the outer house, and you would also have heard me briefing journalists in advance of the decision of the inner house that we would win before the inner house.
I can confirm for the benefit of the tape, I can confirm that this is true.
That's ever so kind of you, gents.
It means that it's all still to play for, so to speak. But what is the current legal situation regarding the prorogation then?
Well, our understanding is that Parliament...
Lawyers! Go on.
I plead guilty to that, Charles.
Yeah, fair enough.
Our understanding is that Parliament is now no longer suspended, so Parliament is not prorogued any longer. Parliament can continue with its critically important business of holding this abysmal government to account. There's a lot to do.
But that's astonishing. I mean, that means they could all just turn up later this morning. They could all just return to Parliament and expect the doors to be thrown open.
I imagine that the Speaker is thinking of you at this very moment about exactly...
And does the Speaker make that decision? I appreciate we're erring into relatively uncharted waters now, but it will be down to the Speaker, will it, to decide what this ruling means with relation to the current suspension?
They're not relatively uncharted waters, James O'Ryan. We're in There Be Dragons territory. No one has the faintest idea.
Thank goodness for that.
What happens now? There has never been any precedent.
But do we know who's in charge of the decision? Is it the Speaker's purview?
I don't know who's
Good
in charge
grief.
Of the decision, no.
Do you know, I wrote some time ago, Jolyon Moore, that those three words, I don't know, are underused, but I think this is one of those mornings where you actually recognise the full weight of the horror. Nobody knows. This is amazing. So we will wait for the next chapter will be written by we're not quite sure who, but the chapter after that begins in the Supreme Court on Tuesday.
That is absolutely so. On that, of that we do know.